And they stalk? Wow. Right, so next speaker, Agustinus Wibowo. He's an Indonesian travel writer and photographer of Chinese descent who grew up in East Java and lived in China. The question of identity dominated his earlier life, which then created his unique perspective in seeing the world around him. His years of overland journey has brought him to the Himalayas, the borderland of Central Asian republics, and the deepest corners of Afghanistan. Today, he will take you to imagine if we live in a borderless world. Can we? Here is Agustinus Wibowo.
Good evening. Shall we start? Okay. When I was a kid, my mom used to tell me lullaby stories from our motherland, China. It's about the Great Wall. She said it's the greatest and the only man-made structure that you can see from the moon. The wall was built by China because to protect themselves from the attack of the northern barbarians. In fact, it's a giant border between the civilized world and the uncivilized one. Back then, if you are born as me as a Chinese minority in Indonesia during the Suharto regime, it might not be the funnest thing you have in your life. People used to mock me because of my slanted eyes. I thought there were only two types of people in the world, those with slanted eyes and those with the rather bigger ones. So the first time I went to China, I thought it was a homecoming. I remember that my mom used to say, hey, don't learn from those Indonesians, oh? We Chinese never speak, oh? But people in this country speak like, aren't we the same Chinese with the same slanted eyes? Don't we share with the same ancestors? So what is borders? It took me years of traveling overland, countries to countries, border to border, until I arrived here. The Amu Darya is 20 meters wide of river separating Tajikistan from Afghanistan, but it separated the life for 100 years. People on this side travel for 2 to 3 hours by car, and on that side, 2 to 3 days on donkey. And many of the times, the border is invisible, like the border between Uzbekistan and Kyrgyzstan. It's in the middle of the alley, and sometimes it cuts through people's houses. So the kitchen is in Kyrgyzstan and the bedroom in Uzbekistan. They say, like, never deliver your babies in the kitchen, otherwise they will be foreigners. People in Uzbekistan worship this guy, Tamerlan, as the national hero, even though he wasn't even an Uzbek. And the people in neighboring Iran and Afghanistan say, oh, he's just simply a savage barbarian. So whether someone is a great leader or a bastard, it really depends on from which side of the border you see him. And Central Asia is the paradise for border lovers. Here you can see a tiny Tajikistan completely surrounded by Kyrgyzstan, or a little dot of Kyrgyzstan completely inside Uzbekistan, or a tiny Uzbekistan village inside Kyrgyzstan and inhabited by the Tajiks. Only God and Stalin knows why. For most people, we cannot choose our border. If you see the map, Indonesian West Papua and Papua New Guinea is separated by a straight line drawn by Westerners thousands of kilometers away who never even considered that there are people living on this island. So the suffering of the Papuans today are related to this absurdity. But borders are as old as our civilization. People in the desert make war because of who control the oasis. People in the jungle is about the hunting ground. So border is about our survival. That's why we carry border everywhere we go. Your ID cards, credit cards, bank cards, passport, visas. Those are borders on paper. When our Malaysian neighbors can just pack and go to Europe, we Indonesian passport holders know to prepare documents as thick as this and to be scrutinized as we are going to be refugees or terrorists. And the refugees themselves, they are also victims of border. Circumstances made them, they have to leave their country, escape from their border, crossing many borders until they want to find the final place they can call home. But once they are there, they will say, I don't belong to this place. And people there also say, you don't belong to here, just go home. So they said that borders are there to give you protection. But is that true? The longer and stronger the Chinese built the Great Wall, the more enthusiastic the northern barbarians come to attack China. And do you feel safer after all these years of war on terror? And how many lives has been sacrificed because of protecting border? But people keep creating border. In the past, they may kill you because you don't have God. Now you have God, they may kill you because your God is different. Even your God is the same, they may kill you because your prophet is different. Even your prophet is the same, but your guru is different. Your way of prayer is different. Your time of prayer is different. There is always reason to be different and to kill. And people can sacrifice themselves to fight for their land, their tribe, their nation, their God, their faith, their language, their gender. It seems that all problems in the world are caused by borders. But if you see deep into every core of every border is about power. That's why we dream about a borderless world. How beautiful it is if everybody just live at peace. We are just human beings. No more Indonesian, no Australian, no Syrian. We can travel everywhere without passport, without visa. We are just, there will be no nation, no nationalism, no army, no war. Oh, utopia. And with this utopia in mind, European nations dissolve the borders. But guess what? A country without border is like a home without wall. You start lose control on your own land. You start lose control on yourself. And your insecurity mounted. And in the end, you would scream, please put back that fucking border. Border doesn't create differences. It just reflects to it. So in a borderless world, everybody would just speak the same language, believing the same religion, wearing the same clothes, having the same hobby and the same sexual orientation. You choose to be you. You will be just a citizen of the cosmos. But the story behind every border is about fear. The border right starts there. Yes, inside your head. So before that, you have to ask yourself, whether you think the border is dangerous, then it is. If you think that the border is your protection, then it is. If you think that the border can be dissolved, yes, surely it can. Because the most dangerous border is not the physical one, but the psychological one. When the Pakistanis tell you that Indians are the worst enemies, or Indians may tell you that, oh, the Pakistanis are the worst terrorists, don't just take their hatred by heart. You have to visit both sides and experience, because the only way to understand border is by going beyond border. Then you will see that we all cry for the same despair, we all laugh for the same joy, and we are on the same journey to pursue happiness. And at the end, we will go to the same ending. By going beyond border, you will see that I am you and you are me.